Glenn, let's talk a little bit about the shortages that we've seen in the industry. Because there's so much demand and so many people wanting to go back, and because places like hotels and restaurants are having such a hard time finding workers, you've had, you know, some hotels either limiting occupancy or saying they're not going to be able to offer a lot of those services. Does that impact what you guys are doing in any way?
I don't think so, but I definitely understand the issue. And certainly, look, we hear this all the time, people saying that, hey, I'm right now, I'm very comfortable what I'm getting in terms of my unemployment or my supplemental stuff. It's summertime. I'm not sure I want to go and take that job right now. I'll think about this in the fall. And that's certainly hurting the hospitality industry tremendously, because those are the type of jobs that actually the level average pay is not high enough above what you would get without working right now to really drive a large percentage of people to go back to work. So it's certainly hurting some of the players in the industry. But again, I expect that will work itself out over either higher wages or over summer ends. And people say, hey, you know, I think I'll go back to work.
You hear about some people who have left the industry and maybe found higher paying wages somewhere else in an Amazon warehouse. Maybe they've moved into construction or done something else. Is it going to be hard to fill those jobs just to find the, is that a longer term, more structural problem? Or you think that clears up as soon as some of those extended benefits go away?
Well, the wonderful thing about market economies is that prices rise to fit what the needs are. What I also think is going to happen is technology, and you may have seen some of this, where certain of the large chains for the casual dining area are bringing in more automation. For example, you're ordering using your phone instead of having a person take your order. Other types of technological solutions in terms of automatic vacuums that are vacuuming the hallways in the hotels. Lots of things. What happens is when labor wages are going up, technology is then seen as an alternative, and that will change the structure. Mm-hmm.
Higher prices creep in other places. We've heard about trying to rent a car, how difficult that can be and how much more you're going to pay just because so many of those car companies got rid of a lot of their supply of cars during the pandemic. What other things do you hear from travelers? What are complaints that come in or maybe things they hadn't been anticipating?
Well, the one you just mentioned is really quite phenomenal in terms of what it costs some places to get a car rental. And that has certainly made some people say, I can't go to that place. I can't afford that car. There is no car. So I'm going to choose a different location. That's definitely happening. And of course, as you pointed out, a lot of the fleets were downsized, and it's taking time to upsize them because, as we know, there's that whole chip shortage in the auto industry right now. So it's hard to get a lot more cars into the fleets. And that's a problem. The other issue that I think you'll have is the confusion. And this is something that I think everybody is frustrated about, and that is governments not working well together around the world to come up with some consistent ways that people can be able to go from country to country. If you're a proven safe traveler, I've got my vaccinations, I'm a safe traveler, and wanting to make it easy to go, governments are just not working well together. We heard President Biden talk when he went to the UK about maybe there'll be a transatlantic bubble between the UK and the US, and that's now not happening, apparently. I think the whole industry would really like if the governments get together, come up with ways, systems, processes, so we can all travel safely, but more easily.
Does part of that include some sort of vaccination passport?
Absolutely. And you have it in the EU right now. The green certificate is now July 1. It goes live. And that is a good thing. But even that's confusing. People saying, well, I'm not sure. How do I get one? And what if I'm from the U.S.? Do I get that? No, you can't get it, by the way, if you're from the U.S. And that's the type of thing that can be very, very helpful. And it'd be great if it wasn't just the EU, but if there's some sort of global green certificate that we could all use and be able to travel safely.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.